Oh, it's that time again, the best time of the year. The Holiday Cube is up, and I'll be drafting it. Also, I kick things off by opening the best card in the Holiday Cube, Soul Ring. Sorry, Jace the Mind Sculptor, you do make the top 10 or so. Factor Fiction, not bad either. Thran Dynamo, a card I like, but Soul Ring is the nut card. See, in a cube where every card is great, and every card you put in your deck is great, being able to cast cards that cost 4 mana on turn 2 is just broken. Yeah, I'll be taking Soul Ring. I also don't know, as is my tradition, what's in this cube. I don't really look at the updates, so if things are here that I did not expect, well, we'll see what those are. I don't know what decks are supported. I know that Ophiomancer is pretty cool, but that's about it. All right, we've got Consecrated Sphinx, one of the better finishers. I do like the Sphinx. Demonic Tutor, pretty great. Dimir Signet, also great. It's going to be one of those three cards, I think, pretty clearly. Bayou's not bad. I'm not taking Courser here. I'm not taking a random white Planeswalker or a Thragtusk, just because these cards are so much less powerful. I really do like the Signets. They do a lot for you in terms of acceleration, mana fixing, and artifact synergies. Demonic Tutor is also really good. You don't really want a DT for Soul Ring much, but having Soul Ring in your deck makes Demonic Tutor better because you're spending mana to get the best card out of your deck, and when you have access to a lot of mana, that is better. I think I'm going to lead off with Demonic Tutor over Soul Ring and see, or over Consecrated Sphinx and Dimir Signet and see where we go from here. Huh, Torrential Gearhulk, I like it. This card's got to be great. Tinker's also great, though. And the presence of Tinker means that I'm much more likely to have good things to Tinker for. Also think Ancient Grudge is highly underrated in the Vintage Cube. Had I taken Dimir Signet, I'd be happier taking Tinker, but honestly, Demonic Tutor and Tinker are also a good combo, so I'm going to take Tinker here. So leading off with a Tinker and a Soul Ring this early seems like it's pretty nice. Seems better than taking Torrential Gearhulk as potentially one of the other options. Recruit of the Guard, what is this? Ah, I see, it's like a Imperial Recruiter, but slightly different. So there's Vendilion Click, I do like me a Vendilion Click, and there's Shellbok Isle. Those are the two cards I'm really considering here. Smokedust Copter is cute, but pretty good enough for the cube, I'm sure, but not for what I've got going on here. I do like Duress, but I think Vendilion Click's a better version of Duress, just because it's a little more aggressive, can threaten Planeswalkers, just a more powerful card, and it's blue. I like cards that are blue. I do like Shellbok Isle, though. They're both pretty good. I think I'm going to just take Vendilion Click. I think Vendilion Click is excellent. And Shellbok Isle, I think, is better in the like legacy versions of the cube, because games tend to last a little bit longer, and there are fewer ways to cheat on mana. Games are pretty fast-paced in the Vintage Cube, and even though I'll gladly take Shellbok Isle high and play it, I'd rather just have something that's active a little earlier, like Vendilion Click. Alright, next up, we've got Trinket Mage, which can go get me a Soul Ring. That is a powerful pick, plus if I pick up a Mox or something along those lines. I don't hate Sensei's Divining Top, because it just combos with Tinker and is good as Soul Ring. I mean, a lot of cards are good as Soul Ring, but top does make up for the mana inefficiency there. I think I'm going to take the Trinket Mage, though, because it can go get me a Soul Ring, and gets me another Tinker target, and good in this kind of blue deck. Not a whole lot else. I mean, I like Izzet Charm. Burrits is okay, but I think I'd rather keep my options open here. I'm not really committed to anything but blue cards here, which probably doesn't surprise you given that this is, in fact, a Vintage Cube. Alright. Celestia Signet and Golgari Signet are pretty low in the power rankings, but Golgari Signet does provide black mana and a Tinker target, or Tinker Enabler. There's also Impulse, which is just a fine card. I think it's either Impulse or Golgari Signet. I do like Young Pyromancer in this cube, but right now I'm not really looking to Pyromance. I've got Tinker and Demonic Tutor so I can finish the game in a big way. So even though I might end up playing it in this deck, I think I'd rather have Signet or Impulse. And it's going to be Golgari over Celestia if it comes down to it. Question is, do I take Impulse? I think I just do take Golgari Signet, though. Ooh, Duretti, Scrap Savant. Discard up to 2 cards, then draw that many cards. Sack an artifact to return an artifact from your graveyard to your battlefield. So, Duretti is good in a deck with Tinker because it works well with the same kinds of cards that are good, like giant artifacts. Burning of Xinyi is also pretty good. Better than Temple of Deceit or Taiga, I think, though. I do like Temple of Deceit. I think I'm just taking Duretti, though. It feels like I'm going to be leaning towards this artifact theme, and I think Academy Ruins also supports that. Plateau. I love dual lands, but red-white, not really where I'm looking to go here. So let's just take Academy Ruins. Ooh, probably take Lodestone Golem. Good with Soul Ring. Not really going to tinker into a Lodestone Golem, but I think it's powerful enough to play early. And also, I do like Riftwind Cloudscape, but I'd rather Lodestone here. All right. Still pretty cool. Maybe take Lava Claw Reaches. No, I'll just take Firebolt. Firebolt has some utility. It's more of a sideboard card, but it could be good. Ooh, I like Electrolyze over Ice Crown Scepter. Nothing to Scepter so far. I'll take Manic Vandal. I think Manic Vandal's solid. No Smuggler's Copter for me, and I actually do think Fiery Confluence is a good card. Soulfire Grandmaster is good if you get Time Walk, but that's about it. So Fiery Confluence, basically because it can kill a bunch of small creatures and destroy some artifacts. All right, so let's start curving a little bit here. So these are the cards I'll be playing early, and then these are the... And then over here we've got our spells. And a little light on mana fixing right now. I'm nominally Grixis, one black card, a couple red cards, a couple blue cards, with a Golgari Signet. No other fixing, so gotta work on that. I'll take Geist of St. Traft. I think Puppeteer Click's not a card I'm really looking to play. Ooh, Burning Last? Okay, that could be a Wildfire deck. I'm in for that. Alright, what do we got? Ooh, Chandra, Torch of Defiance. She does not seem bad. Neither does Memory Jar or potentially Metalworker. I do like Mox Diamond. I also like Time Spiral and Simic Signet. Alright, we've got some options. This is it Signet, that'd be fairly easy. Two Planeswalkers to go quite well with Burning. Red seems fairly open. Mox is not bad. Signet's not bad. I don't think I need Time Spiral here. It doesn't really go as well in the Burning type of decks. Metalworker is okay, but I'm a little light on artifacts right now. I mean, I could take Metalworker and pick up more artifacts. Chandra does seem pretty sweet. If I can play an early Chandra, she seems like she kills a creature and then can enable things like Burning, and the exile of the top card of library effect is also quite good. But Red seems pretty open. There's a chance she wheels, and if she doesn't, Koth might wheel, though Koth is much worse in this kind of deck. Kind of leaning towards just taking Mox Diamond here, but maybe the Signet's just better. Moldriver's also good, by the way, so yeah, this is a tough pick. There's a bunch of, like, good options, but nothing, like, great. I think I'm just going to take Mox Diamond. I really like Mox Diamond. Then, of course, there's this pick, but it has Scalding Tarn. All is not lost. Yawgmoth's really good in the Storm-type deck, but we're not there. Scalding Tarn is exactly what I need in terms of mana fixing, so I'll be taking that. Ooh, I love me a Glenelandra Archmage. What? Another Fiery Confluence? What is going on here? This is a cube, right? Okay. Well then, two Fiery Confluences. I don't really want two, so whatever. I like Everflowing Chalice too, plus you can Trinket Mage on 3 for Chalice and play it on 4, but I'm just going to take Archmage. Archmage is just busted. Phyrexian Metamorph also very good, by the way, but Archmage still just busted. You just play Archmage and you win. Probably take Gitaxian Probe here. I don't really want any of these random off-color lands. And... Yeah, I mean, Ring Delight's fine, whatever. Ooh, Ancient Tomb. I like me an Ancient Tomb over Wandering Fumarole and a second Nahiri. Yeah, I guess doubles are just showing up. Sure. Whatever. Ooh, Sphinx of the Steel Wind. We might have a winner here. And the reason I like Sphinx is that I need something to tinker for, and Sphinx is going to be better than Mindslaver in that regard. Over Torch Fiend. I do like Mindslaver, but I like Sphinx. Sphinx, Sphinx, Sphinx. Alright, Thought Adele is not bad. She goes and steals artifacts out of your opponent's deck, but I do like a Goblin Welder here. I'm in an artifact-heavy deck here, and I'll figure something out. Ooh, Inkwell Leviathan. Inky also works with Duretti and Tinker, so I like having two Tinker targets. This works. Not a big fan of Smokestack. Ooh, Chandra and Metalworker both wield. I think I'm actually in the Metalworker camp at this point with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 artifacts, and I can probably pick up some more. All right. Let's work some metal, shall we? Alright, Goblin Darkdwellers versus Exquisite Firecraft versus Kolaghan's Command versus Nevenril's Disc. Disc actually not completely unreasonable here. Darkdwellers can get back DT, Tinker, Electrolyze, and Gitaxian Probe. It's not horrendous. I don't really like Firecraft. I don't think I want to splash black for Kolaghan's Command, though Kolaghan's Command is the best card here. Let's just take the Darkdwellers, even though I'm probably not going to play it. I guess I could take second Fiery Confluence. I mean, I like the card. Whatever. I don't really want Nicole Bolas. I don't think we're going that far up the chain. I'll just take Bonfire, even though I don't think I'm playing it here. I could sideboard it in. I could see Nahiriing as well. This is the kind of deck where Nahiri could be decent. And Torch Fiend's also a fine sideboard card. Alright, going into pack 3, what do we want to open? I guess if we're getting multiples and just another Soul Ring, I'll take that. yeah, basically the artifact power is really what I'm looking for here. Though, I suppose I wouldn't complain if I got an Ancestral Recall or a Time Walk or something along those lines. Oh, or nothing. Yeah, this is like a Legacy Cube first pick. I'm probably going to take like Wormcoil Engine, which I'm not really happy about, but Wormcoil is good with Burning. And with like Goblin Welder and Metalworker, so sure, I guess we're Wormcoiling. It's a fine Tinker target, I suppose. All right, what do we got here? Well, this isn't the kind of mocks I wanted. I might take Ancestral. It's a good card to suspend early and is nice with Goblin Dark Dwellers. Sacred Foundry gives me access to white mana, which I guess helps with Nahiri. Marsh Flats doesn't do much for me. Don't like Mental Misstep. I think it's more of a sideboard card. Chrome Mox is okay, but not like super thrilled about putting Chrome Mox in my deck. I don't really want any of these cards. I guess I'll take Ancestral. But not thrilled with it. Still not super happy with how this is going. I guess I'm taking Hedron Archive now. Not really gushing. Windswept Teeth is the wrong kind of fetch land. And Archive at least helps me cast my big things. This pack has been kind of disappointing. Alright, well, this helps. Guild Lotus is just a great card. It does a lot of what I want. And I've got between like Metalworker and a Signet and a Sol Ring and an Ancient Tomb ways to cast it early. So I will take Guild Lotus over Orzhov, Signet, and Remand. I like both those cards as well. Ooh, see, here's where all the cards are, including Second Season, Past, and Char. Thirst for Knowledge, Mana Leak, and Coalition Relic are all great. Probably just going to take Coalition Relic here. I do like Thirst. It's good with Goblin Welder, but Coalition Relic is just too good. So I've got like medium fixing or acceleration, like 3, 4, and 5 drop acceleration, which isn't exactly where you want to be, but this is not bad. I kind of like where we're at here. I don't need to start Manic Vandal if I have 2 Fiery Confluences. I'll just play both, whatever. Goblin Welder is actually not looking great here. I don't really have any ways to discard my artifacts. Ooh, Polluted Delta to go get... Nope, I don't have less Steam Vents. So Polluted Delta would just be a blue-black land, which is still good because I have Demonic Tutor. Also, Mystical Tutor, which isn't bad if you have Tinker and Burning to get, but I think I'd rather just take Polluted Delta here. Sorry, Kiki Jiki, not today. Well, there's a Splinter Twin and another Mystical Tutor. Probably take Mystical Tutor now. I mean, I could take Phyrexian Revoker. Don't think Phyrexian Revoker's great, and I think I actually would play Mystical Tutor in this deck. Maybe just don't play Ancestral. It's not like I even thought that card was great when I took it. Ooh, Mere Battle Ball? I do like that, but I've got Wormcoil and 2 other big things, so maybe I just take Snappy. Snapcaster, Probe, Tutor, Electrolyze, Tinker. Not much of my sideboard that gets Snapcastered either. I could just take the Battle Ball. And the Battle Ball's good. Maybe Goblin Welder gets in there once you could do that? Yeah, still probably not. Not playing any of these cards. I guess Through the Reach is the closest to what I might play. Alright, I don't mind Python Needle because you can just play it as a cheap artifact for Tinker and you can give up your artifact count for Duretti and Metalworker and whatnot. Probably not starting it, but I think it's a fine card to sideboard in. Lightning Helix? No. I guess I could take Gush, even though I don't think I'm playing Gush either. This deck's a solid medium. Without Sol Ring, it would be heinous. But because I have Sol Ring, I'll just draw Sol Ring in my opening hand some percentage of the games, and it'll be great. I also think my matchup is very dependent on how good Fiery Confluence is, because I have 2 of them, and they can be good. I'll take Dual Caster Mage. I'm not playing Mischief's Factory. I just can't afford the colorless land. I don't think I'm playing Dual Caster either. Sure, whatever. Take a Char, hide it in my sideboard. So right now I'm playing 16 lands. I actually don't think I'm playing Academy Ruins. I think my mana is just not very good. So, yeah, alright. I'd rather just not play Academy Ruins. There aren't that many artifacts I need to get back anyway. So, still 16 lands. Let's see. How do I want to do this? Do I want to cut anything? 16 lands with Sol Ring, Signet. Mox Diamond isn't really a land or a spell. Probe. I could only play 1 Fiery Confluence. I could also cut a Lodestone Golem. If I don't draw Sol Ring, Golgari Signet, or Mox Diamond, Lodestone Golem is a little slow. Maybe I'll cut Lodestone Golem and just see. I'm just play 17 lands. 7, 1, 5. So 7, 8, 9, 10 blue sources. This gives me 1, 2, 3, 4 black sources, which is probably fun. Oh, plus Coalition Relic and Guild Lotus. Yeah, that's enough. And then 5, 6, 7 red sources. Kind of need... Oh, wait, there's planes in there? Sorry, Sphinx the Steel Wind. Maybe I'll cast Sphinx off like Guild Lotus or Mox Diamond, but it won't happen very easily otherwise. 6, 7, 8 red sources, 9 red sources, 10 red sources if you count Guild Lotus. Alright. I guess let's do this thing.